Doug Nation, what's happening? It's your boy, big homie, OG Doug Bro. You know, we back. It's not, I'm sorry, Blaziken, it is not a TCG unboxing. If you did not check the thumbnail, I am doing a Nintendo Switch review. I have not. I am one of the few who have gotten theirs day one. I didn't open it. Like, what? Like, who does that, right? So, I personally been getting hit up about, where's the video, Doug Bro? Why are you not even playing it? Like, yo, I've been busy. So, you know what I'm saying? I'm here. I'm gonna give you all the review. You know what I'm saying? Don't fret. You know what I'm saying? Hey, your homie today? Yo, today I got time, cuz.
Cuz, I told you I ain't got time for that, but nigga, today I got time, cuz.
So yeah, man, that's that. You know what I'm saying? I'm here. Today we're gonna do the unboxing. We're gonna do this together. I have no idea what's about to happen. Okay, so look, boom, boom, okay, ta-da, boom, sparkles. I don't know the effects of any of this photo editing stuff, but sprinkles, wow, look at that, it's fireworks. You think of my hands are fireworks. Pew. So, look, I'm scared to open it, but I know if something is wrong, I probably need to return this as soon as possible. I have been looking at reviews, or not even real reviews. It was just like some people posted pictures. You know, I'm Reddit. I'm a Reddit guy. You know what I'm saying? Reddit gang. Shout out to the homies. People have been like, yo, this the actual main console inside of here has been scratching. People don't know how to put the Joy-Con stuff together, and it's been jamming. Like, they put in the plus part connected to the minus. Yeah, that's been going on. The actual console system itself has been like blue screening. It hasn't been reading cartridges, and I'm like, yo, I are scared. So you know what I'm saying? So I don't know what to do, but an unboxing needs to be done. I need to open this. You guys need to see this. So we're gonna do this live. Everything is live. Yo, it is literally Wednesday. It is like 11:34 Eastern Standard Time. So when y'all get this video, it's everything's gonna be legit. So, okay, I'm not gonna show this here. You probably already seen like half of it. But as you see, of course, you get the plug. As from what I'm finding out, it is a USB-C. Okay, it is a different size cable that most manufacturers have been using. That's the cable here. Bro, I do retail. The cable, the plug itself, dude, this is $30. I'm like, yo, you gotta get out of here, Nintendo. That's what I'm at already. $30 for the cable, right? But USB-C is not fairly used everywhere. I know they do it in, like, data transfers when you're doing hard drives. Where else? Some HTCs, not HTCs, ZTEs. ZTEs, cell phone companies use USB-C. That cable alone is, like, $20. So I'm like, Jesus Christ, bro, that is, but I'm hearing it's like a USB 3, which is supposed to be faster charging, things of that nature. Of course, it's telling me to set up, remove some stuff. If I break this, this is going to be live on camera, so it's going to be hilarious. I am a little under the weather, so if I make some weird noises, it's going to be weird. Unfortunately, I pre-ordered at my retailer, and they stated if you pre-ordered, you do not get a color choice. You okay? I started seeing. Oh, hey, look, there's my face. Hey, look at me. All right, that's a no. Yeah, so it's gonna be weird. Shout out to Squeaky Chair Gang. Of course, this is the system. Like I stated, this is a USB-C, and auto-adjusting would not show that. I'm pretty sure it would not, but that is a USB-C. This is my first time opening this. I am scared. Hopefully I am one of the few who did not get a horrible defect. I am hearing it. One thing I can tell you for sure, charging is going to be so much fun. That's the charger port. So when you charge, you really don't have, like, there's the camera, you really don't have a legit, like, space to play. Like, you can't really, like, set it on anything when you're charging, because they decided to put it on the bottom instead of, like, somewhere on the top. So yeah, that's that. But let's see what else we got. Okay, I almost broke that already. This is the kickstand. I think this is as far as it goes. Okay, that really looks like it's about as far as it goes. Yeah, okay, that's okay. No, this isn't a kickstand. Is that a kickstand? No, it is not. This is where your micro SD. That's where your micro SD card goes. That is not a kickstand. All right, so for those who are getting the system, that is not a kickstand. That is your slot for your system, for your system memory. And I take it these are the slots where your Joy-Cons will go. Your left and your right. And up top here, these are the vents that I'm hearing do absolutely nothing. Like, they're very aesthetic just looking. Like, I'm trying to see if I can, will it focus? It's not going to focus. So, anywho, so that's the vents that don't exist. This is where your game card goes. Here, game card goes in here. Has a headphone jack, seems cool. Power button, and this is your left and right volume up here. I mean, all in all, it looks pretty dope. But I know, just like, look, dude, you can just like fingerprints already. That's one thing I'm not going to like. But it has this weird feel, like rubber texture. I'm hearing, like, you can't put nothing on it, like sticker wise, because the material that is like on the system coated with is not really sticker friendly. Like, it ruins the paint. Yeah, so that's that. We have, of course, the Joy-Cons. Is that what these guys call it? Yes, the Joy-Con controllers. Also, these are like $70. And I'm like, yo, Nintendo dogs, what y'all boys doing? So, yeah, you have two. Side story. Yo, I probably shouldn't be talking about that. But, so anywho, I have no idea what this guy is. This is the Switch. Oh, this is that controller thing that you can put everything in together, I'm assuming. I don't know the names of these, so forgive me. But I can see that's where your controllers go. Your left and your right. That's what it looks like, right? And so, oh, look, yeah. So this is the plus side. And then, of course, you got your X, A, B, and Y home button. Of course, you got the right analog. You got the right bumper, you got the ZR. Hey, I like the sound. Sounds pretty cool. And then if you're doing, I guess, side stuff, I don't know. Yeah, you got these two buttons as well. There we go. And then I'm pretty sure that's for syncing. But anywho, let's see. So that should go here, right? Right? That's a no. Okay, that's a yeah. Right? Okay, cool. My question is, how am I supposed to... Oh, okay, so you press that to let it go? Okay, that's how you get it off then. I was really just about to ask, like, yo, how do I get this off then? I was about to cry on camera. So, anyhow. Slide that in. It's going to be a long video of just random stuff of how I'm trying to figure everything out. So, I guess this is the controller. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna get that pro controller. This looks weird. It just literally like a block with buttons. Nintendo, what are you doing? So I'm guessing this is your C-stick stuff. What a normal C-stick would do, like on a 64 or GameCube controller. That's your C-stick. This is, I guess, maybe your left and right. This is like your camera stuff, and then that's your actual movement. I mean, it looks cool. It looks cool, and I like how they made it into a controller type-esque look. And shout out to them for getting a release button, so you know the stuff doesn't slide out when you're using it. Oh, hey, look, it has like the little VR things on it. Not VR, infrared IR, I'm sorry. So that's pretty innovative. So you press this button on the back here to release it. That is a question / telling you. Yeah. Let's see what else is in this box, yo. So that's that. Put this to the side. I am a slight messy neat freak. I'm one of those guys. Like, I would make a huge mess, but I would keep it in piles so I know exactly what it is. Because I have no time for that foolishness. Alright. So, I can tell you one thing. I've watched enough videos to know that these have a specific way to go. You cannot match up, say for instance, this one Notice how it has a plus. You can't match this with a minus. Because if you do, you have to do it this way. And for some reason, it doesn't go, okay, correct. It doesn't go that way. And it locks. Like, people were, like, almost about to kill themselves trying to get it unhinged. Which was hilarious to watch. Because some dude, like, peeled his thumbnail back. And it was sick, dude. Oh. Anywho. So, I'm taking it. These belong here. So, you match your symbols together. I know that. Shout out to Sesame Street. So, you put your plus and your pluses together. Sorry, I had to make sure my camera doesn't go to sleep. There we go. Booyow. How do I release this? I don't know. Should probably look into that, too. But this, I guess these pressed actually what was inside here. Your Z is like the ZS or something like that. So you can play like this. But it's going to be weird, dude. That is crazy how you have to play like that if you're doing like a multiplayer with like different people with your screen. That is going to be funky. Yeah. So lock. Unlock. Wait, what? Okay. No. No? How do I? Okay. Wait, how do I take? Oh, okay, James. It should be the same button. It should be? No? Nintendo help. Wait. Yo, wait. Wait, wait, wait. Wait a minute. Oh, God. Wait a minute. I think I did it. Oh, God. Wait. Yo, wait a minute. I think I did it wrong. Wow, I was talking all that smack, and I think I did it wrong. No. Because that releases the mechanism there, right? I'm pretty sure this is how it goes, because it shouldn't go. Yo, I think I messed it up. I'm scared to do it this way. I'm so scared. Because if that's the mechanism, I'm pretty sure it's this way. But it slides on so smoothly that I'm really concerned. Yeah. Alright, I broke it. I did exactly what they didn't want to do. But it literally looks... I matched them together. So then... You know what? Let's look at the instructions and see what I went wrong. This isn't the instructions, is it? This is the safety warnings? That nobody ever reads. I take it this is to remove. Okay, so let's take a look at this. This is the notorious stand that I'm hearing that is like ruining everybody's system. Okay, from what it looks like, it's literally like a block of plastic. Two USBs. Here, this is gonna be a long video, guys. Two USBs here. Serial number for stuff. I have no idea what this does. This is where you hide all your cables at. So you got your AC adapter, which is for your USB-C, a USB for something apparently, and this is your HDMI, probably the charger. This is, I don't know, and this is your HDMI out. That is crazy how everything fits into this. But inside of here, from what I'm hearing, like if you don't like really carefully, like apparently this is like really notorious for like scratching your system. But this is how you're supposedly supposed to charge it. So you slot down here and have it connect, have your system connect the port, the USB on the bottom here to the actual system. So that is going to be fun. But for right now, let me take a, so it's three, okay, three USBs, two USB 2.0s, and one USB 3.0. There. You can see it by the blue that you cannot see, apparently. Yeah, you see that blue line? That's how you recognize a USB 3.0. So, yeah, let me take a look real quick and see where I went wrong. Oh, and apparently, I guess this tells you, it's like a symbol TV. Maybe this is what's going to tell you whether or not that you're connected 100% to the TV or that it's powered through this main block. But yeah, Reddit suggests that you maybe buy some Velcro, like the felt part, and have it like on the inside of the actual unit here, and hopes that you do not scratch your screen. Of course, it's always recommended anything with the screen, you probably want to get a screen protector. Use precaution just like you do on your phone. Just be safe. But felt seems like the only reasonable thing to keep it from scratching on the actual plastic surface of the, wait a minute, that makes no sense. Wait. How am I supposed, wait. Okay. I'm personally thinking out loud, if the power goes here, right, into this light that you can't see, I'll try to get it back into the light, it's a USB adapter part here, I'm talking out loud until I figure it out myself. How big is the port for this thing? Okay, it's very short. No, I don't know, dude, because the inside, let me show you. I don't know, dude, it's not gonna show. Let me see if I can grab. Boom. Let me see. Right there, right in the middle of these two knobs is where it's supposed to connect for your charging. Right? But normally, say like for instance, if you have a normal docking system, well, it could. You're supposed to. It's supposed to be like a actual male unit coming out. I'm trying to show my finger. It's, you know, it's supposed to stick out or protrude out so it can connect into your female port here. But that does not look like the scenario here. It's very short, but I'm assuming because of this notch here. I don't know if you can see this groove. There's a groove like right in here. There's a groove that coincides with the inside. And when you slide down, maybe it gives it more space for the actual device to, you know what? Let me take a look at something. I might have a hypothesis on how this works. Or a theory, let's say. Well, either way, a hypothesis. I state that these knobs should push down, and they do. There we go. Okay. So, look. My concern was, how is it going to, like, how is it going to attach itself, male port to the female on the actual system? This is how it's going to work. Hey, shout out to my phone, though. You can see my stuff. But basically, that's the flashlight. Alright, so you see this nub, I'm going to shine the actual light on the nubs. One's there, and one is there. So the weight of the system, the actual switch system, pushes down this whole black tray that the nubs are on, pushes it down, and then the male portion of the USB-C protrudes out, and that's when it will connect to here. Everything makes sense now. So, alright, so that's that. I still need to figure out what did I just do. I'm pretty sure I did this wrong. And attaching Nintendo Switch Joy-Cons, controllers, batteries will also charge. So, when attached to the Nintendo Switch console, the Joy-Con controllers will also charge. Press to remove. Wait, to remove, okay. Bro, they really didn't give you, like, any instructions. So this is the instructions. So I did it right from what it looks like. You can't see that. I know you cannot see that. But there's the plus icon, and the black part is also the plus icon. But how do I remove it? I have no idea. So, okay, I'm not freaking out, I guess, as much as what I thought. But it says lock. So then it means that it should press here, probably. So I need to go up, right? There we go. That is bad. I don't like that. I don't like that at all. But what is the lock for? I guess the lock is to keep it from when you press the button. It doesn't come apart. So that's the unlock, this white tab here. And then you press on this back button here. And just push up. That is, bro, I thought I was gonna break it. Then no, I don't like this at all. Alright, so let's press. Alright, so it is taken apart. That is funky, bro. This is how stuff breaks, dude. This is definitely, so I'm pressing the button. You gotta like strong arm this thing. Make sure that is pressed down again. Oh god. Alright. Nintendo, you're asking. This is why they're $80, because they know you're gonna break them, so that you're paying more. Alright, so that's that one. Tab is down. Make sure you press the tab down so you can take it out of the unlock position. And then just push up. Jesus. Okay. Okay. Bro, I am sweating. I'm going to put this back for right now. That is there. Take the Joy-Con holders and take this to the side. So literally, bro, the box really contained a piece of plastic hardware thing. I have it. Yeah, that holds the actual system, which is the huge screen. It came with a bag that held these individually, another side bag that was in the cut, one that held here and one was held here for that. And what else did it come with? In a bag that held this. No real instructions. There's no instructions in here whatsoever. So, yeah, good job, Nintendo. Cause, dude, look, literally, there's nothing. It's just a box. So, good job on that. You literally asked for failures for Nintendo on this one. The Wii U had no problems like this. I can't even function right now. So let's put this back. I might cut this little part out. But anywho, look, alright, trash is gonna go back in here. When I say trash, I mean the whole system. Joking. But So this is the, well, you know what, let me clean this up. Let me make sure I'm not missing nothing. So, it says, step one, plug it in. Okay, I think I can do that. Step two, set it up with the configurations. It says, when attached to the Nintendo Switch console and charging, the Joy-Con will charge as well. It shows you how to remove this, but it definitely didn't show you how to remove these guys that's been notorious for breaking everybody's Joy-Cons or fingers. How to remove that from here. Yeah. You get cool designs on the side. And the system itself on the side here. Let me see if I can show you that a little. And the box design that was there. You get no instructions on what to do at all. Wow. Look, I understand that gaming companies do not care for like It's just like nobody reads the manuals for like video games, so don't put the manuals in there. It's a waste of paper. So they give you like this sheet and be like, hey, go online for to go online for more instructions, or like for the actual gaming manual if you actually cared, you know, go online to this site to look at it. But for a system, I'm pretty sure it should be like illegal not to have a actual manual for a system, because there's a setup. What if somebody doesn't know how to set up a HDMI? What do you mean? What is this cable? Nobody's fairly new. Like USB-C has been around, but for actual everyday functions, not everybody has been seen or been using a USB-C. There's folks to this day who has no idea what a USB-C is. And to implement this on this system and not really explain anything, or not even have a manual that says, hey, well, this goes here and that goes there. Cheap, bro. That's my gripe right there. There's no real initial setup instructions on what does what. Because to me, out of the box, I basically just figured it out myself. Can I show you this? It comes with the HDMI. So I think I have enough of those. I'm probably gonna unplug my Wii U for the time being. Let me, you know, before I start down smacking Nintendo, let me make sure there's no hidden manual anywhere. Ta-da, there's nothing. So wow. That is weird. So look, so this is the only thing that came in there. Was it says basically the Switch has been designed for an ease of use. It says to get started, follow the setup instructions on the packaging. So they're talking about those 1, 2, 3 steps. Okay, so it doesn't tell you how to install this. They don't really tell you what this is. You just kind of look at it and kind of figure out what it does. It definitely does not tell you what these are. And so this is where people were messing up, because they do not explain to you anywhere what the heck these things do. Yeah, that is crazy. So, alright. That's issue. Well, I have several issues, okay? Because this everything is going like all together, and this is going to be one huge big video, and I'm not going to do really too much chopping. Main issue, the box setup suck. There's no instructions on really what to set up. They don't give you instructions on how to attach these, how to deattach these, unless it's really in this manual, which I did not see. It tells you how to wear the Joy-Con, how to clean the system, game card precautions, AC adapter precautions, system and accessories precautions. It does not tell you how to set up the system or what each part of this device actually does. So that's my gripe. Two, it's been notorious for scratching inside here. They don't really have any explanations for that, which is kind of weird to me. I'm trying to fix the camera while I'm talking, so I'm sorry about that in advance. So people online was like, hey, well, if you do XYZ, then you should be fine, which was, hey, put a piece of Velcro felt tape inside in hopes that everything sticks together and the felt will not scratch the actual screen. In my instance, I just said forget it for the time being and bought. Shout out to GameStop. I'm not trying to really send them a plug, so it's not really a shout out, but I got it from GameStop. It's basically a carrying case. It comes with a carrying case, a screen protector. What is it? Yeah, it comes with a cool case. It's a hard shell case. It comes with a screen protector. It comes with a microphone headset. Well, headset with a built-in microphone. It comes with the felt screen cleaner, and of course it comes with like a mini mesh thing and a cartridge holder, so you can keep several games on you at all times when people want to run them fades. You know what I'm saying? $20 though, I was not with it. I think it was 18. Well, no, this is 20, but I paid less than that. When apparently you're a pro member, you get extra deals, like a month. It redeems. Yo, let me tell you something about GameStop. Let me tell you something about these folks here. If you don't pay attention to your power-up reward stuff, every month it automatically takes 5,000 points out of your account. Okay, let me tell you that. So pay attention to your account for your power-up rewards. Every month it takes out 5,000 points and magically redeems itself for a $5 use. If you don't use that $5 use, you basically lost 5,000 points within that month. You have one full month to use that $5 offer. And that's so sucky because they do not tell you that. So all these months that I've not been going to that store, because why do I need to go to GameStop? That place sucks. But they just happen to have accessories. You're losing points. So it's like, yo, you, by the time you're buying more games, you're basically filling back up the points that you lost that you didn't know that you had. And I'm like, wow, guys, cool. So that, just pay attention to that, and just, I guess that's forcing you to be there once a month if you want to make use of the points that you did have, because they stole them from you. Thanks, GameStop. So yeah, that's that. What I am going to do is try to set up the system. Of course, it's going to be off screen. I will try to leave this on this side of the table and try to get everything hooked up so we can see how everything is supposed to run. Power up the system. I actually did buy a game. I bought Bomberman. Yay! While everybody is on the Legend of Zelda hype, I kind of had an assumption that because not too many people are fond of Bomberman, I'm gonna leave it on camera because Bomberman is lit with the glare. Basically, what happens is, because not too many people are fond of Bomberman and they think he might be a Mega Man knockoff, this, that, and the other, it would be a short produced title. This is my assumption. I could be wrong, but they are promoting the heck out of it though, for now, because I mean, it is a day one release. But I'm pretty sure Bomberman will be down the line a short produced game, and I'm not going to say it's going to be hard to find, but it may, you know, may be a harder to find thing, because like I said, it's not something that everybody wants. And so I was like, yo, let me snatch Bomberman, because when I did the release, there were like 600 copies of Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. I almost said Mega Man Breath of the Wild. I don't know why. But yeah, there was like 600 copies of that, like 20 copies of the special edition, the collectors or whatever, of Breath of the Wild, and 4 copies of Bomberman, and like 10 copies of Just Dance 2017, and like 5 copies of 1-2 Switch. Now, what's weird is 1-2 Switch is gone from my area, which is weird. I was like, okay, so 1-2 Switch is taking my whole assumption of what I thought of Bomberman and putting it to 1-2 Switch, because we are sold out. I think a couple other places were sold out too, which is, I was like, oh wow, so it's not Bomberman, it was 1-2 Switch that is going to be the what is it, what was the Wii game that came out, was it like Wii Resorts, like the Wii U Resorts one? Like, it was, that was short-lived, and so it was just like, oh, I should have got that when it came out. Oh, sucks for me. But basically what I am doing though, I don't know if you guys have heard of the Neo Geo. Dude, I'm old. Basically, I want to do what I didn't do with the Neo Geo. I want a whole collection. I'm collecting everything from the Nintendo Switch. I'm going to start rambling. But basically, I want all the games, so I thought that Bomberman was going to be the rare one. This is already like 30 minutes in. I'm sorry in advance. Alright, so I did some initial setup. FYI, apparently, I don't know if you can see that, it is suggesting that I can use that little back part for a kickstand. Just don't overextend the bend on it. That's not a good kickstand. Somebody bends that the wrong way and it's broken. But it encouraged me to disassemble the Switch Joy-Cons from the side units and use them separately now. So, use the left stick, so it recognizes my two, and it has the charging symbols here to let me know that I'm fully charged, I believe. I think, yeah, so your fully charged symbol, I think it goes from here down. Let's see if you can see it. So there's four notches here. So I think it goes from right to left, which should be fine. And then, of course, left to right on the opposite to show you your battery life. So it's saying use the left stick to select next. I mean, seems fine. I heard people say that the left one, the left Joy-Con, loses signal a lot, which is weird, but that's that. So next, I will need the following. Okay, I got my HDMI cable, the switch dock, and the AC adapter already assembled. So we're gonna do that, and that is already connected. HDMI is there, boom. So open the back, and then if you plug the AC adapter into the console. What? If you plug the AC adapter into the console earlier, disconnect it. Why would I do that? There goes, okay. So connect the dock, okay. And an image should appear in the TV. Okay. And an image should appear on the TV the moment docking the console. Okay. So, let me go drop this off on the console. Or on the dock. That's what it's called, the docking station. Alright, so now we're back. Basically, we are at the home screen of the Nintendo Switch. There's six different icons, of course, according to where you're trying to go. Picture album, the controllers, I guess, to check the calibrations, the settings, to sync it up. You got the system settings. We got the sleep mode to turn it off. The Nintendo eShop, you should know what that is. Unfortunately, I did not sign into anything, so I will not be going into that for this video and the news. So let's check out the news because that's pretty simple. But just a heads up, we are on a 2.0 software, so make sure that you update your device. And it has some little tips here and there about your Joy-Cons and all the other fancy stuff. So let's take a look at Bomberman. So basically, we're gonna do this off camera. Hopefully there was one small thing that people were saying that the Switch was not recognizing cartridges, certain ones. So let me tell you what all people were saying about everything that was going on for the Nintendo Switch. One, the controllers were weird. Like it was registering and then it wasn't registering. Okay, mine didn't have any problems. Okay. Number two, you could put those little black things that we had in the first half of the video, the Joy-Con little tabs, you could put those on the wrong way. There's no instructions on that, so that's still an issue. I still didn't see anything on the site that told you anything about what to do with those. Those were just in the box, okay? Number three, people were saying that the screen was blue. Or, like, the screen was showing, like, a blue screen. Or it was kind of already damaged. It was missing pixels. What else was it? It was making weird, funky sounds, like, after a while. I did not have any of those issues. So, yay for my Nintendo Switch. And then this is one of the main parts, or main issues is, what is it? Basically that the cartridges that comes with the system, not with the system, but the games that you buy are not being recognized on the Nintendo Switch. Wow. So hopefully I don't run into that issue. I've been batting pretty good so far. So basically what we're going to do is go ahead and put this in. Boom. All right. Super Bomberman. So we are good to go on that. We lit. And let's try it out. There's a software update. Let's go ahead and do that. Alright, so the update is basically done, so we are good to go on that. I probably won't get too deep into this. As far as, bro, this is already like a 40 plus minute video of me lollygagging, but just talking a lot about some pros and cons. I personally, as of right now, find no issues. I mean, like I said, people had issues with some controller things. I have not seen that. Dude, I think I am going to love this. This is my initial, basically, unboxing just to show you what was in the box. I mean, look, we can give it a go just a little bit. So that's that. So we can go ahead and get this a shot. This is crazy loud, and you're probably gonna get nasty feedback, so my apologies. Like I said, everything seems to be working controller wise. I have no problem with this. So like I said, I'll probably be Twitch streaming this now that I have the capture card working properly on this. So you could probably catch me later on today. It's officially Thursday on It's Duck Bro Twitch channel. I'll link it down to the bottom below, or when I am on, you can check me then through the channel. It should notify you as well. I'll probably be streaming it through YouTube as well. So in a nutshell, like I said, man, it's the Switch. It's a little rough. I mean, people had some issues, but I don't like the fact that they didn't really give any clear instructions on how to basically set up the system. As far as the extra devices that it came with, it was more of a let me figure it out. And we seen from people's rants that it didn't go well. So that might be a little thing there. But other than that, man, the Joy-Cons, I thought it was going to be a weird feeling, but it feels very comfortable in my hands. And I have pretty big hands, you know what I'm saying? Tell your girl, though. But I'm probably going to love it now that the fact that this could be a handheld system. So while I'm like chilling downstairs or something or whatever, I can play this on the go. Will I be taking this to other people's cribs? I do not know that yet. I am very paranoid because your system is literally that screen. So it's wrecked and you are going to be hurt and out of $300. So, Duck Nation, we're going to keep this a little bit shorter than normal. I can't even say shorter than normal, dude. Y'all hang this far, man. Y'all did good because I am pooped. I was fighting with the Elgato, so this is almost like a 4-hour project just for recording. Let's take a look at the story a little bit while we're talking. So let me know in the comments below, did you get your Switch? What color Switch did you get? Are you even hyped for the Switch? If you are hyped, what games are you getting? What games are you looking forward to? What do you think about the internal hard drive? I think it's only like 32 gigs internal. I should probably look that up. Let's take a look at that real quick. That should be a system setting. Oh yeah, there's an Amiibo thing. What about system? Hey, Duck Bro Switch. This is definitely not the right time. So it's New York then. There we go. Now when I changed it the first time, it was like, nah, you good. Anywho. Console battery. I would like to see the percentage. I was trying to see if it showed data management. There we go. So internal, I think it is a 32, but a lot of the basically operating system is on it. So you got 26 basically gigs to use internal, and I think I actually have something on this hard drive or SD card. So but basically that's a 32 as well. So I have 64. But for what I'm hearing, like your data saves can be moved, this, that, and the other. And say for instance, if you run out of internal memory, you will have to start deleting things, which is weird too. But when that situation happens, of course I will be back to report on that. But the rumor is basically that if you run out of space on the internal, you will have to start deleting things in order to progress on playing something else different, which would suck if Nintendo actually did that, and I hope they did not do that. But, you know, okay, all right, I keep talking. This will be for another video, okay? So, Duck Nation, it's been real. I'm pooped. I know y'all tired of hearing me talk. If y'all looking for the next video, if y'all want to do an counter, because I'm pretty sure I said, like, 40 times already. But Duck Nation is real. Stay. I don't even have a cool saying. I don't know what to say. Stay fluffy. Nah, but yo, We out.